this is Dave Dirks with Dirks Outdoors. You know, sometimes when you're a beginning fly angler or you're interested in learning how to fly cast, one of the things that I recommend before you spend a whole lot of money on a rod, and this might sound a little different, is to actually buy something that can actually you can practice to and get a feel for fly fishing before you get too far and too deep into it. One of the tools that, and this happens to be one created by Orvis called the PractiCaster, is actually a tool designed to do exactly that, to give you the opportunity to practice and visually see your fly fishing techniques evolve. That it's a little bit more difficult to see or to understand when you're actually using a real fly rod. A real fly line is obviously thinner. It's a little less easy to see. When you have a short little rod like this with really, you know, this, I guess, you know, this hot line that you can see visually. And I have a little yarn, piece of yarn tied at the end so I can actually see where my fly would land technically. But this makes it a lot easier for you to visually see how your back cast and your forward cast are moving along and what you might need to do to get that rhythm. It builds muscle memory. It builds hand-to-eye coordination, so you have the ability to kind of really get a feel for what you're trying to do with a fly line way before you commit yourself to doing it with a rod. And of course, this is one of those investments. I think at Orvis, this might sell for about $59, which might seem like a lot of money, but when you consider the time that it'll save you in terms of learning your fly casting technique, it's a good investment, and it's one that you can use again and again. It's used for adults, it's used for teaching kids, anybody at all ages really learning to want to learn how to fly cast should probably take a look at investing something like this. And in this video, we're going to do a couple of basic casts. We'll just give this thing a real run for our money. Okay, before we start actually doing a little bit of fly casting practice here with my PractiCaster, let's talk about grip and gripping the rod handle itself. So, you know, there aren't too many variations of this, fairly standard. I suppose everybody has their little tricks and tips, but basically the rod, as you want to hold it, you should hold it like this. So the thumb is on the top of the handle. Of course, your reel would be typically here. But basically you're gripping it and not gripping it like a death grip. It's basically just a firm grip, thumb on top, and that kind of gives you the energy that you need to kind of keep that line going forward. Again, and I also often see people, for some reason, their grips will end up, you know, their hand will end up at the sort of the base or down on the lower end of the grip. I would say just make sure you're into the meaty portion there. Your thumb should be a little bit higher, almost to the top of the cork that you see there. And that way you're generally going to be in good shape and generally not suffer from too much fatigue during the day. But that's basically what you want to do, is be able to hold that rod just like that. And again, not with any kind of death grip. Okay, so let's start with some real basics. You know, I don't know if you're, depending on how long you've been fly fishing or, you know, what your experience level is, one of the things that you'll commonly hear people when they teach fly casting is sort of the movement of the rod from the 10 o'clock to the 2 o'clock position. And that's one thing that I definitely say that is a real value to any beginning angler and any angler of any experience, is you definitely want to watch the rod. This is the 10 o'clock position, sort of visualize it from a clock, and this is the 2 o'clock position, roughly. So 10 o'clock, 2 o'clock. What you're really learning here, and the PractiCaster really helps us do that, is you're really learning timing, and you're really learning to let the rod load. And that's really the key to getting a good loop, is allowing the rod to do all the work. A lot of times, fly casters are just kind of learning to get into the fly fishing, often try to muscle it, much like beginning golfers do when they learn golfing. They'll try to muscle the ball and really try to swing that club hard, as opposed to letting the club do most of the work on their swing. You really don't have to swing a golf club very hard, although obviously, you know, people do. But let the club do the work. Well, the same thing applies for a fly rod. And that's exactly what I'm doing here. I'm basically stopping at the 10 o'clock allows the rod to load, the back cast loads, and then the forward cast, back cast, forward cast. A lot of times you see beginning anglers come down to like almost the 9 o'clock position. And that's not really good. That actually lowers the amount of power that you have in your forward cast. So you just basically want to get used to, and again, the PractiCaster is a great tool for getting the rhythm down on the fly line and gives you a chance to understand and visually really easy see. Look how easy that is for me to see. You can see it as well as I can. If I had a fly rod here, it'd be a little bit more difficult to see that action and that energy in that line. And again, of course, you know, one of the things that, again, 10 o'clock, 2 o'clock, is that you're always trying to get a sense of accuracy, you know, delivering the fly, whatever fly it is, on the water, in the spot that you want it to land, is part of the job that you have as an angler. And one of the ways to kind of remember the best way to keep accurate is just to remember wherever that tip, wherever this tip is aimed at, generally, that's where the fly is going to go. It's the same for spin casting. If you aim, you look at the tip of your rod, and you see where your cast is generally in that direction. And that's the same thing here in fly casting. That's what generates the accuracy, is you really have to understand and visualize. Again, hand-eye coordination is important. This kind of practice rod allows you to kind of get that hand-eye coordination so that you can really get an understanding of, hey, wherever I put that tip of that rod, that's where my fly is going to land. And that's really, really important. So again, 10 o'clock, 2 o'clock, if you could do this with a PractiCaster rod, again, look at my timing. I'm waiting for the rod. I'm not really rushing it. I'm not trying to do this. You know, I'm not trying to snap it. If you try to really muscle it, you hear little whips or snaps in your back cast. That means that you're really trying to force the power. The rods, fly rods are built for the fly line that you're using, whether it's a 4-weight or a 3-weight or a 5-weight or a 7-weight. That rod is really designed to do all the work. You're just kind of moving it along and giving it some help. Okay, so remember 10 o'clock, 2 o'clock, remember that the tip of the rod is where the direction of that fly is going to go. And just do this, practice, practice, practice. Makes it perfect. This is Dave Dirks for Dirks Outdoors. Hope you're enjoying yourself in the outdoors, and we'll see you again soon.